Good evening, fellow Lasallians and friends, and welcome back to Bro & Co, where we bring you freshly brewed conversations on life, learning, and St. LaSalle. Thank you very much to all of you who have been with us since the very first episode. For those who are joining us for this episode for the first time, I'm Brother Luigi Enriquez, your newest brother in school, and I'm excited to talk about things that matter most to you. For this episode, our fourth episode of Bro & Co, this is a bit special than the others because this January, we actually celebrated a lot of milestones or historical days in our Lasallian history. And we also look forward to many more days of Lasallian heritage with us. And just to name a few, we celebrated a day in January, which is the International Education Day, and the Lasallian Mentors Day, which was last January 26th. So if you have a teacher or if you're a teacher, happy Lasallian Mentors Day to you. And thank you very much for participating in the Lasallian mission. Just to give an idea of why it's celebrated on January 26th, it's actually a very important day in our Lasallian history because in January 26th, in the 1700s, that was the day that the Institute of the Brothers of the Christian Schools was declared official in the Roman Catholic Church. So basically, we got to prove the Lasallian society that St. LaSalle founded during his lifetime got an approval from the Vatican. And that is something that is very historical in our Lasallian heritage, Lasallian story, because that was the time that the Brothers of the Christian Schools as a group were approved. And at the same time, that day also marked the transfer of the relics or the earthly bones of St. LaSalle. That was the time that it was transferred to Rome, where it is currently staying. So for this episode in Bro & Co, we have with us different people in the Lasallian mission, different personalities, to talk about our Lasallian story and Lasallian heritage. We have a student, we have alumni, we have brothers, we have Lasallian partners, and of course, we have parents to join us here in our fourth episode of Bro & Co. So let's begin our conversation on things that really matter most to you. And let's talk about our Lasallian heritage and Lasallian vision for 2021. We have with us Mr. Fred Angeles, the director of the Lasallian Ministries, Ed Lilo, a third-year accountancy student, and an aspirant of the DLSL brothers. Hello, Sir Fred and Ed. We have the Canovas twins, Kat and Mao, who are alumni, and we have Doc March, an alumni and also a parent here in DLSL. The last, and of course not the least, would be Brother Emong. I'm sure you know these brothers who will join us in this episode, Brother Emong and Brother Marvin. Right. So good day to everyone. Thank you very much for joining us here in our episode. I'm glad that all of us are safe, all of us are here, and we're willing to talk about our Lasallian story and Lasallian heritage. So for this episode, we're going to really just talk about our stories as Lasallians. That's why it's very interesting that whatever field or whatever Lasallian vocation you are in right now, we share a common identity as Lasallians. So let's begin. Maybe we could introduce ourselves to our audience and to each other also by sharing our Lasallian story. So you could mention your name and then share a story, your Lasallian story. So maybe we could start with Ed.
Hello po, good evening to everyone. Magandang gabi po. Ako po si Ed. Pwede niyo po ako tawagin Ed or Edrian. I think I started my Lasallian journey when I was in grade 7, 2012 po yun, pumasok ako sa Lasall. And currently, I'm still learning through this journey. In a third-year college na ako. And yun na po, noong 2018, I was a contact. Pero ngayon, aspirant na ako, di ba? Improving po. So, yun lang po.
Yeah, thank you, Ed. Sana mag-persevere ka sa aspirant. Sir Fred, kayo po.
Good evening, everyone. Ako si Fred Angeles. Currently, I am the director of the Lasallian Ministries. And at the same time, teacher din ako. Nag-start ako sa Lasall 1991. I was, fresh ako from the seminary. I decided to stay outside, no? And then, during that time, I do not know that Lasall is a person or a saint. I just know that Lasall was a school. Okay, but when I entered the De La Salle Lipa, that I learned who De La Salle is. And actually, akala ko mahaba na yung buhay ko sa loob ng seminaryo, pero at this point, nalampasan pa niya yung itinagal ko sa De La Salle kaysa sa naging formation ko sa seminaryo.
Ayan. Salamat po, Sir Fred. Canovas twins, Kat and Mao.
Hello po, good evening. I am Marie Canovas po.
And I'm Kat po.
We're 2014 po. Nag-start kami as student leader sa DLSL Lipa. Marami kaming orgs na sinasalihan. So, first year pa lang, alam na ng Lasallian community, lalo na yung mga student leaders kung gaano kami ka-bubbly, ka-ingay. Ano po, lahat ng offices ata, hanggang brother's office ata, na kilala kung gaano kami ka-ingay. Hanggang na fourth year kami as a student leader bilang isang SG officer. So, yun, may mga ups and downs din kami. Meron kami mga struggles sa org. May mga nawala kami org. Meron naman na pinasok din kami org. Ganun lang yung buhay namin as a estudyante. Sabi nga nila, parang nag-full-time na daw kami sa pagiging student leader kasi parang nanilid daw kami sa mga classes. Pero napabalansin naman namin yung apat. So, masaya yung naging journey namin as Lasallian student leader. And doon nila kami tinuruan talaga kung paano kami magkaroon ng engagement sa community. Kasama ko yung twin sister ko sa journey ko as a Lasallian student leader and I'm proud na hanggang ngayon sa alumni, na-apply namin kung paano sa St. John Baptist de La Salle, tinuruan kami kung paano kami mag-care sa poorest of the poor po. And yun. So, ayun po, nasabi na naman po niya lahat. Wala na naging spot po. Nasabi na po niya lahat. So, ayun po, I think that's it po.
Salamat, Captain Mao, or Konova students. Brother Marvin, how about you? Can you share to us? Ano yung Lasallian story mo? Pwede rin sa story mo sa De La Salle pa.
Naku, napaka-similar actually dun sa twins. When I was still a student, I was also active in school. I was part of the volleyball team. I was part of the drama club. I was part of the student council. And really just immersed myself in whatever the school can offer. And perhaps that is why I think the Lord called me, you know, to be a brother. It's because I really enjoyed my life as a student. And I love to be able to replicate my experience and make it better for the children entrusted to my care. And siguro yun talaga yung gusto rin sa akin gawin ni Lord, no? Because this is my, if I'm not mistaken, seventh year as a brother. Pero nalipat na ako in different communities. So mga tao na nasa Lipa, hello, kasama niyo ako dyan last year. And I believe that as a Lasallian, wherever I am sent by God, no? Hopefully I could be able to respond how God wants me to respond, no? In every situation.
Okay. Maraming salamat, Brother Marvin. Mamaya tingnan ulit natin yung kwento ng Lasallian story mo dito rin. And kung saan ka ngayon, di ba? Kung anong pinagkakaabalahan natin ngayon as a young brother. Maraming salamat. Doc Marge, kayo po. Welcome to the show.
Hello po. Good evening. I'm Dr. Marjorie Reyes Felix. I've attended De La Salle schools for 7 years. Graduate of high school, De La Salle Lipa, batch 1995. And nakita niyo naman yung virtual homecoming namin, so yung journey namin doon. Si Sir Fred, isa siya sa mga naging religion teacher ko, saka mentor sa ALSA. And then after high school, I went to De La Salle University. So I took BS Biology for 3 years. So 7 years yon. I've been to many schools. I can safely say that I am more green than any other color. And dahil po, I believe in De La Sallian education, my 2 sons have attended the De La Salle school. So like my son, Ruben, he had been in De La Salle pa for 9 years. But syempre po, nag-transfer na siya ngayon, grade 7 sa Philippine Science. And then yung grade 4 ko, currently studying in De La Salle pa. And hopefully, pag okay na, pwede nang pumasok ulit. Most likely, yung magiging nursery ko na daughter, La Salle pa rin. Kasi more green kami than any other color po.
Yeah. Maraming salamat po, Doc Marge, for that very inspiring story, no? Talaga, it's a family affair. Thank you. Brother Emong, how about you? Can we know your story?
Ako naman, sobra akong nakarelate kay Sir Fred. Pero unlike him, alam ko naman na si St. Lasallian ay tao din, di ba? Pero ang difference, maala ko, si St. Lasallian at si St. John the Baptist, iisa lang. So, nasuturo na ako yung sa Zobel. I've been teaching for a year sa Zobel. So, anak ko talaga, pareho lang sila until I underwent formation, Lasallian formation. And then that's when I got to know more about the Lasallian legacy. And I fell in love with the practices because as a teacher, napakaganda nung, ano, napakaganda nung reach ko with the students. I meet them every day. Tapos eventually, when people ask me kung anong role ko sa Lasallian mission, I've always been a sharer. I was blessed to have experienced a lot of beautiful things being a Lasallian. And I want other people, especially my students, to experience the same kind of blessing I received.
Yeah, and maraming salamat, Brother Emong. Very inspiring story also, no? Similar to Sir Fred. And speaking of Sir Fred, Sir, I'm very interested with all your stories, no? While listening to you and listening to all of you share your Lasallian stories, I couldn't help but ask, after that experience, after your several years in the Lasallian institution, as a Lasallian, maybe some of you from student pa hanggang ngayon as a parent, or from student hanggang ngayon as an alumni, you're still a Lasallian, right? And after all those years, from your perspective and from your story, what does it mean to become Lasallian? Or what does being a Lasallian mean to you?
Actually, when I started working in the Lasalle, I look at it as just as a work. Merong sweldo ako during 15 and then 30, yun lang. Pero as I go through the formation of being a Lasallian partner, I was able to see a deeper meaning in my work. It is not just a work, but it is a mission. Yun yung itinuro sa akin. Because of that, I was able to love, and actually, even at present, I'm loving my mission as a Lasallian. Ngayon, nasa opisina na ako, no? I love being with students as a teacher. Pero even though I am at the office on managing other LPs, ang trabaho ko din is of formation. Dati ako ang pinoform, now ako ang nagpoform, not only of the students but also of the Lasallian partners. Kaya natutuwa ako na talagang nagle-level up din pala yung aking pagiging Lasallian partner. From the very start of my entry to the Lasalle, now I am now in my 30th year as a Lasallian partner. And talagang mamahalin mo, no, not only the school but the person of the Lasalle. Mamahalin. Right. Kaya totoo na talagang if you really have seen your mission, no, and there you would also find your meaning also as a person. Kaya natutuwa ako na in my 30 years, no, although ups and downs, wala naman journey na laging masaya, pero doon tumitibay ang aking pagiging tao, pagiging Lasalliano.
Hmm. Salamat, Sir Fred. Actually, sir, isa pang question, no? Na nakita ko dun sa sharing niyo po, no? Parang ang tagal niyo sa Lasallian mission as of the moment, no? At first, nag-start kayo, nag-work pa lang, wala pa dun yung Lasallian identity. But what is it in the Lasallian school that actually allowed you to grow in your understanding of what it means to be a Lasallian?
Actually, yung ang nakita ko dito is emulating how De La Salle loved the children during that time, particularly those children who are in need. No? Hmm. And I, being a Lasallian, nakita ko dito na I'm not just here to work, but I am here to respond to that particular call, just like what De La Salle did during that time. And I do hope that even in my years na natitira pa, no, sana mas mapagyaman ko pa yon as a Lasallian. Kasi ang tingin ko dito, ang pagiging Lasalliano ay hindi natatapos sa panahon na kung saan kayo nag-work. It will move and continue even I am not a teacher anymore sa school.
Right. Maraming salamat, Sir Fred. Nakakatuwa yung story ni Sir Don na talagang emulating what De La Salle did, even the person of De La Salle. And I'm sure sa mga students po na naka-encounter natin sa school, meron niyang effect, no? And it would be nice to hear also from our alumni, from Kath and Mao, ano yung naging effect of, di ba, being an alumni, of course, before as a student here in De La Salle pa, how did your understanding of being a Lasallian grow as an alumni na? Wala na kayo sa school, ano na yung naging understanding niyo of being a Lasallian?
Being a Lasallian, na-apply namin siya after we graduated. Nagkaroon kami ng opportunity to work bilang employee sa other companies. And then way back in 2016, nagkaroon na po kami ng sarili naming business, which is Healthy Treats Manila, na we are aiming to lose weight for the other people as well. And of course, nung nag-grow na po yung business po namin, sabi ko, why not balik po tayo sa alma mater, Mau, bilang one of the board of trustees De La Salle Lipa. Kasi na-miss ko ang pagiging student leader eh. So, yun nga po. So, na-miss ko mag-activities, magkaroon ng community involvement. So, nung na-elect po kami bilang Board of Trustees ng De La Salle Lipa Alumni Association, nagkaroon kami ng mga fundraising for the scholarship of DLSL students to our DLSL alumni card. Kasi po, may fee po kasi yung pag-aabi ng alumni card. So, doon po kami nag-i-start na mag-fundraising para po makapag-raise kami ng fund for the benefits of the DLSL students. So, yun po yung aming isa sa mga goals namin to raise fund and to help other people as well.
Wow, nakakatawa naman. Super, super involved kayo sa community even after your stay in De La Salle pa, no? So, how about you, Mau? Do you have anything to add to what Kat said?
Ayun po. Yes, after 4 years po, akala namin, ano lang, alumni kami na parang doon na matatapos yung journey namin as Lasallian student leader. Pero hindi namin in-expect na after 4 years, babalik pala kami sa Lasallian community para mag-serve. So unexpected na may mag-message sa amin na ano yung interest namin to be in the Lasallian alumni board of trustee. Pero may election. So actually, hindi na naman po bago sa akin yung election since nung student council kami, student government, dumaan kami sa election. Sabi ko, another ka ba na naman moment ito? Dahil buong alumni na po yung involved. Hindi na lang po parang college department. Ito po ay buong alumni na. So, paano natin i-aware na sa Lasallian community na ano may nagawa na ba tayo? Parang pinagdasal na lang din namin. Tapos parang bumalik kami sa kapilya kung ano yung mga dati naming routine dati na parang St. John Baptist de Lasalle. Never po talagang nalimutan namin na include si St. John Baptist de Lasalle talaga sa prayers namin. Kasi after graduation talagang nabago niya yung buhay namin, hindi na po as a student, na-apply namin siya sa corporate world hanggang sa nagkaroon na po kami ng sarili naming business. So dito sa business po namin, hindi lang po kami basta parang gusto lang namin mag-earn na mali para umaman or gano'n. Hindi naman po kami gano'n. Kumbaga parang ngayong pandemic, in-apply din po namin na mas babaan din siguro natin yung price para mas lalo tayo makatulong, lalo na sa healthcare frontliners. Nagkaroon po kami ng donation drive. Pero talaga focus kami kung sino po talaga yung mga dapat naming i-serve. Hindi lang po talaga doon sa community namin sa Lasal. So, napunta din po kami sa iba't ibang community para po, dahil at your Lasallian cares for all. So, maganda na pinarila sa amin si St. John Baptist de Lasal na magkaroon kami ng care sa community at mag-give back po sa community. So, ayun po.
Yeah, ang ganda kasi parang talagang from your involvement in the school hanggang sa lumabas, talagang nag-involve pa rin kayo, no? And I'm sure si Ed makaka-relate din dyan sa sobrang daming activities na ginagawa ni Ed sa school. Ed, kamusta naman yung understanding mo of being a Lasallian?
Actually, sobrang nga pong daming activities. Para meron akong tatlong answer doon sa question. Okay, para sa akin po kasi as a student, parang the usual answer kasi talaga kapag sinabi nilang what does it mean to be a Lasallian? I think it's really embodying yung Lasallian core values natin, yung faith, service, and communion. Kasi I realized when I became a student in Lasal, one thing that really sets Lasal apart from other universities or schools, I think it's really parang it provides a holistic education para sa mga estudyante. For example, in my inay program po, hindi lang niya ako minumold as a professional, pero tinuturoan niya kung paano maging servant, kung paano maging isang Christian, or kung paano maging a member of a community, kung paano ka mag-respond in the societal needs, kung paano ka makakatulong to create a societal impact, parang gano'n. The second one, lagi kong naririnig when it comes to parang UAAP, mga competitions, mga ganyan. Animo Lasal. So when you're a Lasallian, then you have that animal spirit. Ano naman yung ibig sabihin ng animal spirit? Para sa akin naman po kasi, when you have that animal spirit, then you have that confidence to fight. You take pride sa kung ano yung naging legacy na ng Lasal. It all boils down into surpassing your limits. Na it doesn't matter kung gaano kaliit o kataas chance for you to win or to succeed in a particular goal. But what matters is, itatry ko to, gagawin ko to. So surpass ko yung limits ko, parang ganyan. And yung last, siguro gusto kong i-relate dun sa sagot ni Sir Fred sa kanina ate Mau, yung parang hindi lang siya natatapos being a student or a professor or a teacher. Yung parang when you're a Lasallian student, you're a student parang habang buhay na and you're open to learning into different kinds of lessons na hindi mo lang siya ma-apply towards yourself but you can also share it to other people. So, natutuwa lang din po ako na ngayon ko na din po kasi na-realize na oo nga, no, when you're a student, hindi ibig sabihin student ka lang kapag nasa loob ka ng facility ng Lasal. Pwede ka rin maging student talabas and you can actually share it towards other people.
Yeah, nakakatuwa Ed na parang habang nakikinig ako kasi parang na-imagine ko rin yung effect talaga ng mission sa students na nakatulad mo na you don't need to wait to graduate to actually make a difference, di ba? In different involvements and engagements that you have. So, good job! Nakatuwa yung na-share nyo. And of course, as students, we also need the support of our elders and adults that are guiding us throughout our journey. It could be our guardians, it could be our parents, no? So, we'd like to hear ano naman yung perspective ng parents of what it means to become a Lasallian. Doc Marge, kayo po, ano pong palagay niyo?
Sa akin po, unahin ko muna yung what it means to be a Lasallian during this pandemic. Kasi ngayon, ang hirap-hirap, ang dami-dami challenges. Parang to the point na hirap na hirap, parang minsan nakaka-cause ng anxiety. So, una, being a Lasallian means rising to the challenges that is being brought to us. Kahit gano'n siya kahirap, kahit parang ang laki-laki na nung bato or nung mountain na nasa harap mo, you'll do everything to climb it and to survive it. Second, being a Lasallian, nakita natin si St. John Baptist de La Salle. Diba, galing siya sa mayamang pamilya, but he sacrificed para lang maturuan yung mga bata, yung mga poor kids. So, as a Lasallian, a Lasallian makes sacrifices for the betterment of the society. So, yun po. As a parent, yun din po yung gusto ko sanang ituro sa aking mga anak na alam niyo po, being a Lasallian means being a good Christian, respecting your parents, respecting your elders, doing everything you can to be the best in everything you do and makakontribute ka sa betterment ng society. So yun po sa akin ang being a Lasallian as an alumni and Lasallian parent po.
Yan. Nakatuwa na ng Doc Marge habang nakikinig po ako sa inyo. Naaalala ko kung paano rin ako nasuportahan ng magulang ko sa Lasallian education. So maraming pong salamat dun sa ginagawa niyo rin po sa kids. And to all our Lasallian parents, of course, thank you very much. This is also your own mission. No? So, and shout out to Mom and Dad. I love you. Thanks for sending me to Lasall. Okay. Brother Marvin and Brother Emong, kamusta naman? Ano ang understanding natin ngayon as brothers, di ba? Anong understanding natin sa the identity of a Lasallian?
Ako actually, a lot of it would come from my experience as a teacher kasi doon talaga nagsimula yung passion for serving na talagang na-cultivate ng Lasallian formation. Talagang pinagpapasalamat ko sa De La Salle Zubel yung formation na natanggap ko. And kagaya nung binanggit ni Adrian, it's the spirit eh. It's more than just what you are doing, it's how you actually do it. I mean, there are a lot of students here in this country, but bakit ang Lasallian student nag-stand out, di ba? Meron talaga siyang qualities that is greatly fueled and inspired by that animo. That inspiration, that animo, that spirit is what actually motivates us to keep on doing what we are doing. When I became a brother, inisip ko parang, what difference does it make? Parang, nagtuturo na ako before. Tapos, magtuturo pa rin ako ngayon. And I realized that for people, it brings a different kind of inspiration. Now, for people, you say something as a brother, and now they look at it from a different perspective. Kaya tinatanong ko nga yung mga kaibigan ko dati, di ba? Paano nyo ako napaniwalaan dati sa mga pinagsasabi ko, di ba? Kasi talagang, to tell you honestly, as a teacher before, there were things that I wish I did not say. and I wish. Like, halimbawa, yeah. Like, as a teacher talaga dati, grabe talaga, they know me for deadlines. My students who know me for deadlines talaga. One of the things that I wish I did not say was I would not listen to any reasons. I would not listen to any. Ngayon parang hindi ko magawa yun. Parang ang hirap mong sabihin. So yung isang bagay na hindi mo maipaliwanag, I think that's one of the miracles that being in this vocation has brought into my life, my personality. And pwede ba mag-second lang sa sinabi ni Doc Marge? Sa totoo lang po, ang take ko dyan sa mga parents, kahit naman po hindi kayo graduate, kahit hindi po kayo alumnus or alumna ng Lasall, tapos pinag-aral ninyo ang anak ninyo sa isang Lasall school, actually, mas nauna pa kayo naging Lasallian kesa sa mga anak ninyo. Because it's your choice that qualified you. Kasi you could have chosen other schools, but then you entrusted your kids to the heritage that Lasall has. So, maraming salamat po, Doc Marge. At lahat ng parents talaga, kasi sila yung unang formator ng mga anak nila and to actually entrust the continuation of that formation to our Lasall schools is really heartwarming.
Yeah. And especially at this time, di ba, na ang hirap-hirap ng sitwasyon, di ba? But still, our parents and their Lasallian families continue to send their kids to school and entrust them to our care, no? So, nakakataba ng puso and very, of course, very heartwarming. Yeah, maraming salamat. Brother Marvin, kamusta naman ang understanding mo ngayon of being a Lasallian? I understand that there is a new document that our institute released, no? And how did that also, you know, enrich your understanding of what it means to become a Lasallian?
What does it mean to be a Lasallian for me now that I am a brother? Well, it is a lifestyle of service. It is inviting us to be able to understand who we are as a person, our gifts, our talents, so that we could be able to use our talents to respond to the situations, just like St. John Baptist de La Salle. And since I'm a brother, parang wala akong choice eh. Parang kailangan ko talaga i-live up ang ating Lasallian core values. Especially now that there is a new document, Lasallian document entitled Declaration on the Lasallian Educational Mission. It tries to answer why we do what we do, you know, who we are as Lasallians, what makes us Lasallians. And hopefully, you know, that in our dialogues, in our reflection, we would really be able to discover and be able to align ourselves to the mission that St. John Baptist DLSL actually gave us. So yun, bro, no, for me, it is really a lifestyle. No, choosing to be of service to others in whatever way, discovering who we are, being able to discover the Jesus moments that happen in our lives. And I think what is more important also is to be able to encourage other people, to inspire other people as well to either join you in the mission or be able to discover who they are as well.
Right. Ang ganda nung sagot mo, brother, kasi parang after everyone has shared, di ba, parang you were able to capture it in one word, which is lifestyle. Di ba? And then, of course, with the document that you shared, it also allows us to understand that the Lasallian mission is not just, number one, it's not just in the LaSalle school, di ba? In fact, the Lasallian mission is supposed to go beyond the school. And it's not just one or two or three sets of people. It's everyone who is living the Lasallian lifestyle in the Lasallian community. And speaking of lifestyle, I'd like to pose this question to everyone. So anyone may answer anytime. So speaking of lifestyle, how did the Lasallian values actually seep into your daily life?
Siguro ako po, brother, sa akin as a student, when I became a Lasallian, I really understood ko ano ba talaga ang significance or yung value ng service towards other people. Na-realize ko po na the opportunity to serve, the opportunity to help other people, nandyan lang yan. It's always there. It just takes parang an open heart or parang kailangan mo lang talaga buksan ang puso mo into these kinds of opportunities. At i-realize mo lang talaga kung anong value nito. Kaya ko rin po kasi sinasabi sa sarili ko na this kind or this act of service, it doesn't need to be something that is grand. Hindi kailangan magsimula agad tayo sa malaking bagay. Kahit na maliliit na bagay lang, kasi parang kahit gano'n pa yung kaliit, it will always find its way doon sa mga tao na nangangailangan noon. Lagi pa po sinasabi, kahit gano'n to kaliit, kahit isa, dalawa, or kahit tatlong tao lang ang makarinig niyan or makareceive ng act of service na ginawa mo, panalo-panalo ka na. So, on a day-to-day basis, parang nakatulong siya sa aking decision-making na parang I got to reflect sa aking mga actions. Gaya nung sabi ni Brother Marvin, am I doing things right? Am I doing this for myself? Is my intention pure?
Yeah, ang ganda. Talagang day-to-day decisions, no? Thank you, Ed. Anyone else who would like to share on how the Lasallian lifestyle has affected your day-to-day decisions and day-to-day life?
Ako, ako parang nasasapian ako.
Teka lang.
Parang hindi ako napapagod. Alam niyo, natatuwa ako sa sarili ko kasi I could not say what Ed was saying a while ago. I could not say that at the age of even 20. Mm. When people ask me about my religion, I always tell them that Zubel taught me my Christianity because talagang before joining, well, di ko nga alam, di ba, magkaiba si St. Lasall tsaka si St. So parang, I really could not say that. Napapasana all na lang ako sa sinasabi ni Adrian na I wish I had that opportunity to unleash my potentials and then to serve other people. Kaya siguro yun nga, nung naging bona fide Lasallian ako, nagwala talaga ako. I would really do a lot of social action programs ng Zubel, even the formation for the lay partners. I would really take part in all of those activities na feeling ko talaga hindi ako napapagod. Kaya nga looking back, hindi, parang pinaya ko yun. Na sobrang dami noon at sobrang ligat noon. But I think what powered me was that animal spirit. Leading back to what Brother Marvin said, eventually, naging lifestyle siya without me realizing it, it has become part of me. Ayun yung nag-iba sa akin. Sinapian talaga ako, tingin ko eh.
Nakakatawa naman, brother. Doc Marge, kayo po ba sinapian din kayo ng Lasallian?
Medyo po. Imagine 7 years na Lasallian po. So talagang sapping-sapping yung Lasallian values sa akin. Share ko lang po. Tingin ko po, yung Lasallian education po taught me to be a good Christian and to strive hard to really be a good Christian every day. Lalo na po sa trabaho ko as a physician. Di ba may sinabi po si Brother Marvin na lifestyle of service. So as a physician, lagi po nasa service industry kami. So hindi po siya parang I am a doctor because I want to earn. It's more of I'm being a doctor because I want to help. Lagi ko nga pong pinagdadasal na sana, every birthday ko po, lagi pong nasa dasal ko, sana Lord tulungan mo ko na maging instrumento ko para magamot ko yung mga tao, makatulong sa kung ano yung kaya kong itulong. So tingin ko po dahil yan sa Lasallian education, sa Lasallian values na nakuha ko, Tapos, as a parent, mahirap po ang magpalaki ng tatlong bata. Tapos po, yung asawa ko po ay abroad. OFW po kasi. So, yung resilience ng pagiging Lasalliano, yung pag-rise sa challenge at yung pong striving na maging mabuti at the best parent, the best mother for my kids, I think talaga po yung sa Lasallian values ko. And I think nag-pay off naman po. Isa-shoutout ko lang po yung dalawang anak ko po.
Opo.
Kasi po, even academics, isa po sila sa mga pinagmamalaki ng Lasalipa. Sila po yung every year, nagkakaroon sila ng tarpaulin sa walang.
Congratulations.
Proud parent po. Kasi being a Lasallian means giving the best and making the best out of my kids. So, yun po. Yun lang po yung ma-share ko. Tapos, shoutout nga din po kay Ed. Kasi for a 20-year-old, nagkanya na yung sinasabi niyo, parang I'm still in awe. Parang, ha? Ako, parang po yung naisip kahit sa age ko ngayon. So, good job, Ed.
Oo nga. Nakakatuwa rin no, yung shinare ni Ed. Kayo naman, kumusta yung ganun na yung influence sa inyo nung Lasallian lifestyle natin? Cat and Mao?
I think that the Lasallian value that I apply in my everyday life is faith in God. Kasi whatever you ask in prayer, you will receive if you have faith. Kasi may mga times na nagkakaroon kami ng mga ups and downs, hindi naman lahat, more on recognitions, more on achievements, lahat ng tao may mga ups and downs. So yung pag-enter namin sa De La Salle Lipa Alumni Association, we guided to the Lord, we guided to St. John Baptist De La Salle. Sabi ko, when we graduated in De La Salle Lipa way back 2014, mag-enter na naman po kami bilang officer ng De La Salle Lipa Alumni way back 2018. Sabi ko, Lord, kung hindi po para sa amin, i-elect niyo yung mga deserving na po position sa De La Salle Lipa Alumni. Kasi po, gusto po namin na maramdaman kami ng Lasallian Alumni Community, kung anong ginagawa ng community namin, na it is not about the fundraising, but of course, we just want to involve the whole Lasallian community na maging belong sila sa aming alumni community. Kasi what is the purpose of the Lasallian Alumni Community kung hindi kami magkakaroon ng engagement with them. So, para sa amin, hiniling ko kay Lord na kung kami ay ma-elect o hindi, i-elect nila kung sino yung deserving sa position. And then, God answer my prayer. So, that's it po.
Yun po. Add ko lang din po, same prayer din kami. Nasa sentrum ng election talagang kabado kami. Pero mas kinabahan kami talaga na after election, ano kaya yung next sa DLSL alumni community? Since parang kami, medyo bago sa amin yung DLSL alumni na parang ano ba yung mga activities nila, paano sila nakaka-influence ng Lasallian alumni na mag-give back sa Lasallian community. So, yun din yung same prayer din. Si St. John Baptist nila, so lagi kami ginaguide sa mga plans and decisions namin kung ano yung mga dapat namin gawin. And meron nga po kami first mental health project sa Alumni Association, which is very timely kasi nagkaroon tayo ng pandemic. May mga andaming nagkakaroon ng anxiety sa alumni community. So, yun yung naging way namin para magkaroon kami ng empathy sa Lasallians kasi andaming naging unemployed sa mga batchmates namin. So, talagang pinush namin to kahit medyo kakapa-kapa kami sa mga meetings po. Ayun po, si Doc March kasama po namin sa Alumni Association. So, naapektuhan yung events namin. Pero yung naging priority talaga ng Alumni Association na please, ipush natin itong mental health project kasi kailangan ito ng Lasallian community na ma-feel nila na nag-care tayo sa kanila na hindi natin sila iniiwan despite of this pandemic. Na may Alumni Association, silang malalapitan kapag may mga problema sila. Kaya tie up kami sa Lipa Mental Health Chapter and magkakaroon po kami ng mga free counseling. And nag-open din po kami sa lahat kasi a true Lasallian cares for all. Nakakatuwa kasi from Luzon, besides Mindanao, ang dami nag-join ng webinar namin. We're thankful na ginaid kami ni St. John Baptist de Lasalle kung ano ba talaga yung need ngayon ng ngayong pandemic. Parang kami naging instrument para mag-give back sa community and that's all po.
Yeah, nakakatuwa kasi yung initiatives niyo ngayon, connected siya dun sa sinabi niyo na yung Lasallian value of faith, di ba? Yun yung talagang parang nag-push sa inyo. At Sir Fred, I'm sure tuwan-tuwa po kayo from Lasallian Ministries na yung ministry pala natin, di ba? Of course, sa Lasallian Missions Office, di ba? Meron tong talagang nagiging epekto sa ating mga students and alumni. And sa inyo po, Sir Fred, sa inyong palagay, paano niyo naman as a partner in the Lasallian Ministries, paano naman na enrich yung day-to-day life niyo po?
Actually, picking up dun sa mga shinier kanina ng mga kasama natin, sa totoo lang, ang buhay talaga ng isang Lasalliano ay lalo tigit sa akin, tingnan ang lahat ng bagay sa mata ng pananampalataya, looking everything at the eyes of faith. particularly yung mga bagay na dumarating, nakalam ko ba ito, handa ba ako dito, kaya ko bang gawin ito? Just like you, the brothers, no? Na kung saan saan kayo dinadala, kung ano ang position ang ibinibigay sa inyo. Pero ang nakikita ko talaga is all of us talagang kumakapit sa pananampalataya. Na sana ay kasiyahan tayo ng ating patron, ng ating Panginoon na bigyan ng tamang lakas no, at biyaya upang gampanin ang mga ibinibigay sa atin. Sa akin, ang aking karanasan, lalo tigit na inilagay ako sa opisinang ito at sa panahong ito pa, kasi ito yung una kong taon, talagang tinanong ko yung sarili ko na gagawin ko ba ito, tatanggapin ko ba ito, no? Actually, ang konting istorya lang dito, no, it was Brother June who called me up and asking me to take the office. Sabi ko, brother, bakit ako? Ang sabi niya, kaya mo yan. Ano? Ikaw ang tinatawag dyan. Sabi ko, pero brother, pwede ko bang tulugan muna? Sabi ko ganun sa kanya, hindi pwede eh. Talagang kinakailangan ngayon at sagot. Pero yung pala naman, kinabukasan, aalis na si Brother June. And lakas ako ng loob kasi ang makasama ko doon. Yung pala naman, kinabukasan, siya pala inilipat na at aalis na lang nila sa Lipa. Pero tinanggap ko, no, having that kind of faith. And I know itong isang pinakamalaking impluensya sa akin no, ng pagiging isang Lasalliano. Kahit anong mangyari, hindi naman tayo nagyayabang na kaya natin lahat, pero alam natin na nandoon lagi no, sa pamamagitan ng pananampalataya, God will always be there for us. And our patron saint is always interceding no, for whatever work that will be given to us. And participating in that particular mission, definitely all the graces na kinakailangan ibibigay sa atin. Kaya natutuwa ako sa sharing ng particularly ng ating alumni, lalo na ating estudyante na pinakabata ng ating parent, no, talagang nandoon ang pananampalataya. Minsan hindi nga lang natin nakikita na meron pala tayo nito, pero nakikita na agad sa mga ginagawa natin.
Yo. Naman. Yeah. Nakakatuwa po, Sir Fred. Diba?
Yes, brother.
Opo. And Brother Marvin, do you agree with, ano, what can you say about what Sir Fred shared also? Na talagang pananampalataya yung nagsusustain sa atin, that faith that drives us to serve others, no?
I totally agree, brother. And even actually with what the other guests also shared, it is really our faith that drives our actions, no? And then yung sinabi ni Sir Fred kanina na nung tinanong siya ni Brother June, no, na kung gusto mo at ang sagot niya, bakit ako? And in a way, that is also my response to God when I felt that I was being invited to be a brother. No? Nasabi sa akin ni Lord, gusto mag-brother ka? So sagot ko rin, bakit ako? Up until now, I have friends who does not really believe that I am a Lasall brother. That I chose a religious kind of life. Because really, I live my life kind of really differently, you know, than before. Yeah, yeah. But I believe that my Lasallian education really molded me to respond to His call, no? And I believe also it inspires me as well. Kung si Lord nga naniwala sa akin, eh. Sinabi niya, kaya mo yan, eh.
Tama.
Who am I not to believe other people as well? I try to be influenced by that every day, you know, that to see the people I meet and believing that they are also capable. No, that they are all good people, they have good intentions, no. And I believe, brother, no, that as we are talking about all of this, kita-kita mo lang din how the components of our Lasallian mission could really affect our lives.
Right. Thank you for that, Brother Marvin. No? And that question that you asked, parang bakit ako? I think that question is shared by a lot of us. No, not just the brothers, but maybe even our students. Diba? Bakit ba ako nasa Lasall? Right? Even our alumni, why am I being called to this certain mission, right? What does my Lasallian identity call me to do? And of course, our parents then parang anong maya ang bago dun sa mission natin? And you know, listening to all our sharings and to all your stories, nakakatuwa. And what I could see is really that the Lasallian mission goes beyond Lasall, right? The Lasallian mission goes beyond us and goes beyond Lasall. It's really meant to be shared with others so that eventually a lot of people would participate in that mission. Diba? And nakakatuwa because in our very long history as a Lasallian institution, not just De La Salle pa, but the Lasallian lifestyle, the Institute of Lasall, no, in the whole world, we know that yes, there are a lot of changes. There are a lot of situations that call us to adapt to it, to adapt to these challenging situations. But there are people who continue to respond to that call. And I think that's what the spirit of faith, zeal for service, and communion in mission really asks us to do, to respond to that call of God, right? To a particular mission and to be of service to others in a very particular way. Whether you're a parent, whether you're a Lasallian partner, even if you're a student, right? Even if you're a brother, and of course, even if you graduate and leave the walls of De La Salle, Lipa, you are still called to that particular mission. And of course, at this time, we have to adapt and adjust to the different ways that we could understand the Lasallian mission. And so, Brother Emong and Brother Marvin, maybe you could tell us more about Lasallian visions, where we really try to understand and deepen our knowledge and experience of the Lasallian educational mission.
Right, brother. Thank you. No, recently, there is a document that was released by our leaders of the institute that is called the Declaration on the Lasallian Educational Mission. And basically, it talks about what we have been talking about.
Right.
Who we are as Lasallians, what makes us our schools Lasallians, no? Who are the prime movers of our Lasallian education, what are the components of a Lasallian institution, and basically the challenges that we face today. Dati bro, may declaration na document before. But correct. That time, it was just really to really put into writing who we are as Lasallians. But this time, we are looking into it deeper on how we could adapt to the changing times. And at the same time, rather, we look into our different role in strengthening our Lasallian educational mission. So the brothers actually have a project, the young brothers actually. Brother Emong, anong project natin?
Ayun, nabanggit nga nga ni Brother Marvin yung roles, no? Maganda rin tingnan kasi yung document in the light of what you are and what role or roles you perform in the Lasallian mission. Kaya yung Lasallian Visions, by the way, meron po kami a Facebook group, Lasallian Visions 2021. This is a gathering of all Lasallians from different sectors. So we have students, we have alumni, we have parents, teachers, academic support personnel joining the Facebook group to actually initiate this discussion on what actually are our inherent characteristics as Lasallians and our Lasalle schools, what qualities stand out among our Lasalle schools. And this will be a good point of discussion because they can determine where we would like to go. Of course, still considering and looking at the signs of the time, just like how Lasalle would always do it, not relying only on one thing, but he makes sure he listens to God's directions, but then also considering what are the signs of the time. So we would like to extend the invitation to everyone, even on Lasallians, to take part in this dialogue.
Yeah, and maraming salamat, Brother Marvin and Brother Emong, for inviting our Lasallians. Nakatuwa kasi, yung pinag-uusapan natin ngayong hapon, yun din yung pinatry i-express ng document and ng Lasallian vision. So I'm very, very excited to actually find out what will happen in that Lasallian visions gathering that we will have. No? So
can I yes. It's just like to add, no, that it is a monthly dialogue. So the second one would be on February 26 and the third one, March 26. And what happens also, Brother Emong mentioned earlier that we have a Facebook group. We post materials there to help us digest the excerpts of the content of the document. So it would really be nice to hear from all of you. One thing that I'm really excited about is to meet other Lasallians from other places. So I hope that we have encouraged you and to participate on our this one and share your vision of what Lasallian is with us.
Nakatuwa kasi if you enjoyed our conversation this afternoon with a parent, Lasallian partner, brothers, alumni, and student, that would have more guests and more participants in the discussion. So, yun, tama si Brother Marvin na marami tayong ibang makikita na mga Lasallians from different Lasalle schools in the Philippines. And so, maraming salamat. I'd like to sincerely thank our guests for this afternoon, Doc Marge, Sir Fred, Ed, Brother Marvin, Brother Emong, and our Canovas twins, Kath and Mao, for being with us and sharing your inspiring stories about your identity as a Lasallian. And of course, to all of you, maraming salamat for being here. And I hope the Lasallian stories that we've shared this afternoon would allow you to also look at your own story as a Lasallian and figure out how you could respond to the call to actually live our values of faith, service, and communion and mission. So catch us again in our next episode of Row & Co. We'll be having a Valentine's special. Abangan natin lahat yon. I'm excited for that. And I hope all of you would continue to like, share, comment, and subscribe to De La Salle Lipa's official YouTube and Facebook account so that you would know when we have our new episode. So once again, maraming salamat for being with us, to our guests this evening. Thank you very much for sharing and being very bubbly in our conversation. I personally enjoy it, and I learned so much from all of you and got inspired with all your Lasallian stories. Once again, this has been Brother Luigi, and this has been Bro & Co., where we serve you freshly brewed conversations on life, learning, and Saint Lasalle. Catch us in the next episode, Valentine's special. Thank you.